Hi and welcome. In this video, we are going to discuss about wealthy father question from interview preparation marathon in Arrays. Okay, so let's see the problem statement, understand the problem statement, and then we will move forward to the logic building part. Let's see the problem statement. So the problem statement here says that Prep Buddy went to a market to buy toys for his child. In a toy shop, there are n toys placed in a single row. Okay, with a price tag of AI for each toy. Fine. He wants to buy the toys placed in two segments of length L and length R, where segments should be contiguous and should not have any same toys. Okay, so L and R should not have any same toys, but they should be contiguous. Okay, L should be contiguous and R should be contiguous. And it is also said that he will choose such segments that will cost him the maximum amount of rupees. He is very wealthy. So the first segment of length L can be before R or can be after R. Fine, we need to find the maximum such amount. Okay, so if we see the test cases, it is here it is 4, 4, 1, 2, 3, and L value is 2 and R value is 2. Okay, so in this particular case, the segments we can have is 4 plus 1, 2 plus 3, because they are contiguous, or this is only case I think. So 4 plus 1 is 5, 3 plus 2 is 5, so the answer comes out to be 10. In the second example, we have 6, 3, 5, 2, 6, 8, 9. Now here, L value is 2, L value is 3, and R value is 2. Now we can have multiple segments. We can have multiple segments. We can have 6, 3, 5 as L and R as 2 and 6. So here we will get a sum. We can have L as same 6, 3, 5 and R as 6 and 8. We can have L as same 6, 3, 5 and R as 8 and 9. So here we have multiple cases, and from that the maximum answer that we are getting is 32. Fine. So L can be before R. So L can here be 6, 8, 9. That is this. And R can be 6, 3. R can be for same 5, 2. R can be 3, 5 also. That is nothing but this combinations of two lengths, and L is nothing but this. So L can be before R, L can be after R. Fine. So we have to find the maximum, we have to find two such contiguous subarrays of length L and length R such that their amount add up should be maximum. Fine. So this is the problem statement. Now let's see how to build a logic. First, we will see the brute force approach. That is the most basic approach. And using that, we are going to move forward to the efficient approach. So first, let's discuss about the most basic approach, and it is a very direct approach actually. So what we can do is, for each and every L, we can find out the R and we can get the result. So what is the meaning of this? So L value is 3 and R value is 2, correct? So let's say L is 6, 3 and 5. Okay, so what is L sum? So L sum becomes 6 plus 3, 9 plus 5, 14. Now with this 14, all the R that are coming after L and before L can be added. So before L there is no R with length 2. So we can have 2 plus 6, that is 8. So one combination is 14 plus 8, correct? We can have 8 plus 6, that is 14. So one combination is 14 plus 14. And we can have 8 plus 9. So one combination is 14 plus 9 plus 8 is nothing but 17. Okay, and we can have the answer is 31, 28, and 14 plus 8 is 22. So what is the maximum? 31 is the maximum. So each time we will be storing the maximum with us. So maximum is nothing but till now 31. Fine. Now similarly, with this particular case, for this L it is over, so we can now change our L. So 6, 3, 5, 2, 6, 8, 9. Now L can be changed. So what L can become? L can become now 3, 5 and 2. So L sum is nothing but 5 plus 3, 8 and 2, 10. Fine. Now what are the different combinations? So we can have 6 plus 8 because there is no two elements to form R before it. So it can be 10 plus 6 plus 8 is 14, and or we can have 9 plus 8, so 10 plus 17. So none of them are greater than 31, so nothing will be updated. Fine. Now let's move forward and see the next case. So we can move forward now. L value can be this. So L sum can be 5 plus 2, 7 plus 6, 13. And we have the combinations. Now we have a combination before L also of 2R. So we can have 13 plus 9 or we can have 13 plus 17. Okay. No one is greater than 31, which is our max till now. So it will not be updated. Next, we can move forward now and we can have here the next combination of 2, 6 and 9, 2, 6 and 8. Here also nothing will be updated. Okay, you can just calculate it. And now we will have LS value as 6 plus 8 plus 9, which is nothing but 23. Now for this 23, we have one combination of 6 plus 3, that is 23 plus 9. We have one combination of 3 plus 5, so 23 plus 8. We have one combination of 5 plus 2, so 23 plus 7. And in this, 23 plus 9 is 32, which is greater than 31. So maximum will be changed to 32. And we have no other possibility left. So the value that is printed as the answer is nothing but 32. Okay, so this is the most basic approach for this particular problem. Now, to facilitate the sum, so because we need the sum each and every time, as you see, we have calculated 6 plus 8 plus 9, 5 plus 2, 3 plus 5, 6 plus 3, each and every time we have to calculate it. So what we can do is we can form a prefix sum array directly. So it is nothing but 6, 6 plus 3 is 9, 9 plus 5 is 14, 14 plus 2 is 16, 16 plus 6 is 22, and it is 30, and it is 39. So a prefix sum array can be directly created. Okay. Now how do we find, how do we query a prefix sum array? So if it is at index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you want to know what is at index 3, what is the sum, till index 3, what is the sum? So it is nothing but 16. Okay, and if you want to know from index 1 to 3 what is the sum, so you just have to subtract the array a of 3 minus a of 1, the lower bound, minus 1. Okay, so if you have l value as, let's say, the lower bound is nothing but 2 and the upper bound is nothing but 5, so you want to know the sum between 2 and 5, so it is nothing but a of 5 minus a of 2 minus 1. Okay, so a of upper bound minus a of lower bound minus 1. Fine. So 30 minus 9 is nothing but 21. So the sum between 2 and 5 is nothing but 21. So 8 plus 6 14, 14 into 16 and 5 21. Okay, so this is how we query a prefix sum array. So we can calculate this very easily, the sums. But what we need is, for each L we are having a loop for L also, and we are having an inner loop for calculating the previous hours and the next hours, that is coming before L and after L. So therefore this is a basic approach. Now we can move forward with the efficient approach. Okay, once this is understood, the efficient approach is very easy to understand. Okay, so this one is will be used definitely, the prefix sum array, but I will explain you the efficient approach with this array only. Okay, and we can convert it at the end to this array. Fine. So let's begin with the efficient approach. So let's see the result variable. Okay, so this is our efficient approach. We have three variables, result, L, the and R. So I do not know currently what will be my L and what will be my R, but I want to initialize these variables. So I will initialize the result variable with L is 3 and R is 2. So 3 plus 2 is 5. Okay, so I will initialize the result variable with first 3 and first 5 elements. Okay, so these first 5 elements can be divided into L and R. So the result will be nothing but 22. Initially, this is the initial assumption. Okay, L I am assuming to be 6, 3 and 5. So it is nothing but 9 plus 5, 14. And R I am assuming to be 6 and 3. That is nothing but 9. Okay, so L and R, this is not the result. Mind it, L and R, this is not the result. I am just assuming their initial values to be these. Okay, so result is assumed to be the sum of the first 5 values. L is assumed to be the sum of the first 3 values because length is 3. And R is assumed to be the sum of the first 2 values because R is 9. R length is 2. Okay, now we have two cases. Okay, what we are going to do is we are going to use similar to sliding window. Okay, so this nothing but we have 0 to 4, that is nothing but first 5 elements, result is 22, we have seen that. So we will go to 1 to 5 now. Okay, we will shift one position to the right. We will begin with this value, that is nothing but I value equals to 5. Okay, now in this particular array, now we have two choices. The first one is L is coming before R. Okay, L can be before R, and the second is R can be before L. So we have to consider these two cases. Fine. So if L is before R, that means, let's say L is 3 plus 5 plus 2. That is 5 plus 3 is 8 plus 2 is 10. Fine. So with my current L that I am currently checking, so it will be checked. Maximum of the current L that I am having and the L that I am currently accessing. So this is nothing but maximum of the current L I was having was 14 and this L is nothing but 10. So the maximum will be 14. Okay. And now, if this is my L, 3 plus 5 plus 2, so the R becomes 6 and 8. Fine. So the result will be the maximum of the current result, or the L that I have just chosen, that is 3 plus 5 plus 2, and due to this the maximum L that I got, okay, till now is nothing but 14. So 14 plus the R that is there, R is nothing but 6 plus 8 is nothing but 14. So this becomes as 28. Fine. So for this 28, the L that we are choosing is 6 plus 3 plus 5, 6 plus 3 plus 5, and R is nothing but 6 plus 8. Okay, so this 0, 1, 2 index is my L, and 4 and 5 index is my R for this particular result of 28. Okay, so which is L? This 6 plus 3 plus 5 is L, and 6 plus 8 is nothing but my R. So L value is, L length is 3, R value is 2. I got the sum as 28. Fine. Let's move forward now. Now, with this in mind, our first case we have seen. Let's see the second case. Now, for the second case, R comes before L. Okay. So, similarly, R equals to maximum of the current R that we are having. Current R is nothing but 9. Okay. And now R is coming before L. So, R is nothing but 3 plus 5, nothing but 8. Fine. So, maximum of 9, 8, which is nothing but 9. And similarly, if this is my R, so what is the L? L is nothing but 2 plus 6 plus 8. Let's see, we are seeing just this window till now. Okay, 2 plus 6 plus 8 is nothing but 16. So the result will become the maximum of this particular result that we are having, which is nothing but 28, which was updated just before this. And the R we are having, that is nothing but 9. The L we are having, that is nothing but 8 plus 6 plus 2, which is 14. 14 into 16. Okay, so it is between 25 and 28, who is maximum, the result will remaining 28. So till now, what we have seen here is the L and R till this particular index is, this is my L, okay, and this is my R. This is giving me the maximum till now. This is my L and this is my R. This is giving the maximum till now. Now we will follow the same procedure for the rest of the code as well. Okay, exactly the same procedure. What we are going to do, we are going to shift our window to this particular case now. Fine. To this particular case, we are going to shift the window. Now, what can be L? So L can be 5 plus 2 plus 6. Fine. And for the, if L is 5 plus 2 plus 6, so R is 8 plus 9. So this is the one case. The second case is L can be 6 plus 8 plus 9, and R can be 5 plus 2. That is, R is before L and R is after L. Fine. In both cases, we need to also check for the current maximum L and R. For the current maximum L and R. Now, in this particular example, if we see, so L is maximum of the current L. So, current L maximum that we are having is 14. Okay. So, 14, 6 plus 5 is nothing but about 9, 6 plus 5, 11, and 2, 13. So, it remains as 14. So what will be the result? Result will be the maximum of the current result, which is 28, 14 plus, if L was this, so the remaining was R, 9 plus 8 is 17, 17 plus 14 gives me a value of 31. So 31 is my current maximum result. So for 31, what are the values? For 31, what is L and R? So for 31, the R is nothing but, I think, 8 plus 9. So R is this, okay? And L is this, 635. Okay, so this is my L and this is my R to reach 31. Fine. So see, till now L is before R for the maximum result. Now let's move to the second case. Here R will be calculated. So R equals to maximum of the current R. Current R is 9 and it is nothing but 7. So it will remain 9. And the result will be maximum of 31. That is the result that we have just calculated. And if R was this 5 plus 2, so L was 6 plus 8 plus 9, and which equals to 23. Okay, so 9 plus 23 will give me the answer as 32. So this is updated now. So for this, R was this 6 plus 3. This was R, okay, and L was 6 plus 8 plus 9. This was L. Fine, for the 32 result. So this is my maximum answer till now, that is 32. And we cannot shift the window anymore because this is the last index. So the maximum answer we get is nothing but 32. Fine. So this is how we are going to calculate it. Okay, so obviously we are going to have the prefix summary here also. That is going to be really helpful. So first case that we need to consider is nothing but L is before R. Okay, second case we need to consider is nothing but R is before L. Fine. In both the cases, we will calculate the maximum L till now, the maximum R till now. We will calculate the maximum result till now in both the cases. Okay, so this is one set and this is another set. You can divide this into many categories also. Okay, I have just combined them. So L and R can be calculated, then result can be calculated, then again L and R can be calculated, then result can be calculated. This can be done this way also. Okay, but if we have an R, then we do not actually need to calculate L. It is by default the remaining part. So therefore I am not calculating it explicitly. Inside the result only I am just directly writing it. Okay, you can calculate it explicitly. Just have L1 R1 L2 R2. Okay, and Lmax Rmax. We have six variables in that case: L1 R1 L2 R2 Lmax Rmax. Okay, and then using in the result just have the maximum of all those values to get the answer. Fine. So I will just write a pseudo code for your explanation. Okay, and we can run those pseudo code and then we will see the code. So let's see the pseudo code once. Okay, so the result, this is my nothing but the prefix array. Okay, prefix sum array, let's say it is A. So the result will be nothing but L plus R minus 1, which is L value is 2, L value is 3, R value is 2. So 3 plus 2 minus 1 will give me A of 4, which is nothing but 22. So the sum for the first 5 elements is 22. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements, sum is 22. For the first 3 elements, the sum is 14. And for the first 2 elements, the sum is 9. So this is what the result L and R are initialized to. Fine. Then a loop will run where I will start from L plus R. That is nothing but the 5th index. Fine. Now in this, the first we have to calculate an updated value of L. Whether the current value of L is maximum or we need to update it. Okay. So this is nothing but the current value of L, which is nothing but 14. Now here, what we are calculating is at value of L before R. So we are nothing but calculating this part. If you can see, we are calculating this part. Now the sum between the range 1, 2, 3, we are calculating this. So I minus R with 5 minus 2 is nothing but A of 3. A of 3 is this minus A of 0. Okay, so we are calculating the sum between the range 1, 2, 3. So it is nothing but 16 minus 6, which is 10. So is the maximum 14 is still maximum. So we just calculated this one. Okay, the sum between the range 3, 5, and 2. Okay, 3 plus 5 plus 2, so it is still 10. So the L value is still 14. Fine. So now result will be updated. So what is the result? Result here is nothing but the current result, which is nothing but 22. A of I minus A of I minus R plus L. So what is I? I value is 5. I value is 5. R value is 2. So 5 minus 2 is 3. So what we are calculating right here, what L we have, L we already have. Okay. So in this 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, L is 1 plus index 1, 2, 3. What is R? R is index 4 and 5. So we are calculating the sum that is present for the elements between 4 and 5. So if it is 4 and 5, so upper bound is 5. So A of 5 minus the lower bound, which is 4, 4 minus 1. Okay. 30 minus 16, what is what we are calculating here. Fine. So R value is 2. So 5 minus 2 is 3. So A of 5 minus A of 3. This is what we are calculating right here. Okay. So we have L, we have R, we are adding it. So if this result is greater than the current result, so we are updating our current result. Similarly, now we are getting the value of R. So this is nothing but R that is coming before L. So this is for calculating R, which is coming before L. Okay, these are all the values substituted. So we are calculating this R now. Fine. So if this is maximum, then the current L, current R, then we are updating or we are keeping the current R as it is. Fine. Then using that, now we have R. So this is nothing but my L. Okay, 3, 4 and 5. So this is nothing but my L. So L plus the R that we have just seen, adding it, if it is greater than the current result. Okay, so we are updating the result, else we are keeping the result same, and the loop is running again and again. Okay, this I have already explained how the loop is running. So nothing but the sliding window type. Okay, so this was the pseudo code for this particular question. This one in the blue, whatever written is in blue is nothing but the code lines, and in the green is nothing but an example and explanation. Fine. And this white one is the for loop, and this yellow one is also from the loop. And I will just show you the explanation, the code. Okay. So this was this particular question. So it is most commonly known as the maximum sum of two non-overlapping subarray, the question, okay, for the interviews. So we are taking all the respective inputs, then we are calculating our perfect sum array. Then this line I have already explained, the result, the Lmax, the Mmax or the Rmax, okay. And in this case, I value starting from this, then we are calculating the Lmax, getting our result, then calculating the Mmax and getting our result, and finally returning the result value, okay. And here it is printing it. So this code I have already explained, this one. So this is most commonly known as the maximum sum between two non-overlapping subarrays. Fine. Thank you.